Honorable Minister for Home, Government of Telangana, Sri Nai Narasimhareddy Garu. Respected Director, NCRB, Dr. Ish Kumar Garu. Principal Secretary Home, Government of Telangana, Sri Rajiv Trivedi Garu. My esteemed colleague and the conference organizer on behalf of NCRB and representing the state of Telangana, Additional Director General of Police, CID, Mr. Govind Singh, all the directors of the state of fingerprint bureaus, various researchers, students, invitees, the officers of Telangana State Police, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen. We feel happy and delighted today that the two-day conference has come to a successful conclusion on the best practices in the area of fingerprinting across all the states and the union territories in this great nation. As deliberated yesterday, India was the first country in the world to have this fingerprint bureau established at Calcutta. We had that distinction. It is time that all of us, we start thinking how we can make the fingerprint bureaus, the fingerprinting technologies as an integral part of the mainstream policing. Any society, if it has to develop, if it has to progress, maintenance of public order and peace is an essential prerequisite. Then only the governments will be able to govern, undertake developmental activities, welfare programs, and ensure that the efforts of the government fructify in various sectors as per the priorities. Given the importance of public safety and security, prevention of crime, detection of crime, tracking, monitoring, and control of organized crime and criminal gangs in any organized society is the responsibility of the state. And towards achieving that objective, fingerprint bureaus, fingerprinting technologies as a tool for detecting the offenders, for prosecuting them successfully in the courts of law, for tracking the people, for ensuring that the good conduct of the convicted prisoners is maintained over a period of time once they are out of jail. The focus on fingerprints need to go up. Police organizations as a whole today in India, we need to do much more in terms of use of the scientific tools and technologies in the process of investigation, in the process of marshalling of evidence in the courts, in the process of crime prevention, the work relating to the crime prevention areas. We need to be proactive in use of technologies. In my opinion, when Dr. Ish Kumar was mentioning yesterday that in countries like UK, Every police station has a fingerprint expert in the police stations. I think that is an ideal requirement. Every case that we investigate, every occasion that we look for, if we have to go by the scientific evidence, if the community has to develop confidence in police that we are fair, we are equitable, we are transparent, then the use of technology is the minimum that we can do. Yes, the earlier technologies were not efficient. They were not, giving the results in real time. There was always a lag from the collection of chance prints from the crime scenes to the time we get the result, to know the identity of the suspect. But now that the new technologies have come into the market, it's time for all of us to adopt these new technologies. And also, it is not enough if we buy the technologies and then give it to our people. We need to build the capacities. The capacity building is an essential prerequisite for the entire process. We need to train them, retrain them, bring about that scientific temperament in the entire force. As you know, the police organizations have huge manpower. The numbers, the sheer numbers. We need to have methodologies, mechanisms, the institutional arrangements, the training facilities, the expert faculties, and the budgets required for training all these people in these technologies so that over a period of time, we are able to ensure that every average policeman takes the help of this fingerprint expert when he goes to the crime scene. Whenever he has something to verify, he will use and take the help of aid of these technology, fingerprint technology experts at the police station level, at the crime scenes, at all the instances where he is expected to discharge his duties. So once that demand side improves, where average policeman feels that yes, he or she needs to use the fingerprint technologies on a regular basis, then the fingerprinting offices also will come into the mainstream. Now, today the feeling of all the fingerprint bureaus is that they are a neglected lot. They are not in the mainstream. They are within the department. Hardly anybody bothers about them. So from that scenario, we need to bring about this change. That is possible only when we can bring that scientific temperament in the average policeman investigating the cases at the cutting edge level. In tune with this vision, the government of Telangana, especially the Honorable Chief Minister of Telangana State and the Honorable Home Minister, they have been driving, leading the force from the front in terms of providing the necessary resources, the funding, the moral, physical support, sanction of the post, and thereby in the last 3 to 3.5 years, we have been able to get in a lot of technologies, more specifically with regard to this automatic fingerprint identification systems. We have been able to procure and then put in place and then also integrate these systems with the CCTNS. That Telangana is the first state to acquire AFIS, and in addition, we have been able to integrate also with our CCTNS as a first state in the country. So we also have very dedicated officers. Our Director of Fingerprint Bureau, Mr. Prabhakar, is a very dedicated officer. He has a vision for himself. Sometimes I used to wonder when I was a commissioner of police, I used to interact with him calling from the state headquarters and then see how these technologies can be put in place. He was always thinking one step ahead of us. So that's the kind of initiative he and his team have shown. They are the propelling force in terms of taking these technologies forward. It is not only that, after purchase of these technologies, the entire team led by Mr. Govind Singh, Additional DG CID, have been interacting with the field level police officers, giving them the training, popularizing these technologies so that the use is improved on day-to-day basis So that over a period of time, these technologies are used seamlessly everywhere and anywhere. These technologies not only help in identification of the suspects, but they will also act as a shield for the law-abiding citizens. It's a protective shield. In case of any suspicion, if we are able to verify the identity of a person on the spot, the hassle of going through the police verification for days together, being summoned to the police station, being made to wait in the police station for 24 hours, then doing the physical verification, all that, then at the end of it, if he is not involved in any crimes, asking them to go back, this is a kind of harassment to the common citizens. We need to look at their rights, the rights provided by the Constitution. We need to protect them. As a law enforcement agency, our first priority is to protect the rights of the law-abiding citizens. So in the process of investigation, we need to cause minimum inconvenience to the civil society. So as a part of that effort, today I can proudly say that in Telangana police, we don't have to bring anyone, any suspect to the police station. In case any suspect is found anywhere in situ in the field, we are able to take the fingerprints online using these mobile fingerprint devices. Then the verification happens online within few seconds. Then and there the result comes. So it has really avoided people being brought to the police stations. It has reduced the risk of keeping those people in the police stations. It has also enhanced the dignity of the citizens. It has also helped the policemen to understand that it is better this way. He does his job much more to the satisfaction of the people. And this has helped us to apprehend several criminals in the process. About 7,500 people have been just identified with a criminal background when they are loitering around on the streets under suspicious circumstances. In a record time, that credit goes to these technologies and the officers behind this. I would definitely say that what we have done is only a drop in the ocean. Many more things to do and a long way to go. Definitely, we have taken the first step in our efforts to walk the 1,000 miles league. Now we would be doing that. I'm sure the Telangana police, especially the team led by Mr. Govind Singh, they are all enthused after this conference to take all the best practices learned from each one of you to take forward. I take this opportunity to thank Dr. Ish Kumar for giving us this opportunity to conduct this conference in Telangana state. We feel proud and honored that you all have come here. You have given us an opportunity to host this conference, and I am sure our officers have taken all the possible measures to ensure that your stay has been comfortable and your learning has been fruitful. As far as this conference is concerned, sir, we have been able to showcase what Telangana police has been doing for the rest of the country. And we also would like to know from other states what are the best practices in terms of the technology use, the process improvements, the manpower improvement, the process, people and technology in all the three fields, so that we would be able to take better strides in the days to come. I thank you all for making this conference a great success. I thank everyone and especially my colleagues, Govind Singh and all his able team, who have worked very hard for the last couple of weeks and then make this conference great success. I thank you all once again.